last Sunday, and it's been sitting in here. And see, I didn't get the red quite all the way mixed in. You're supposed to, according to B, who is from Sorcery Soap, and this is her recipe, you're supposed to leave this sit 3 days and then work it and then let it sit another 3 days before you use it. So mine has sat seven days, because life got in the way and I couldn't work it in 3 days like I had planned. So it's pretty hard, solid right here. It looks hard and solid, but as soon as I mash this, it's gonna be all gooey. So the inside is much gooier than the outside. And so by working it, you wanna sort of work it so there's no hard bumps, and they kind of help. You can see it sticks to my hands. That all kind of blending, it kind of helps reduce some of the sticky. It's sticky on the inside and not sticky on the outside where it's hard. So as I work it, that white stuff will get blended in. And I'm gonna get redder and redder and stickier and stickier. And depending on what you use for micas, you get more or less sticky. Now I could use cornstarch with this and reduce the amount of sticky that I'm getting. But I prefer not to use the cornstarch the first time I work it. I'll use the cornstarch when I start using this for building, because obviously I can't build anything when it's doing this. So this is so super sticky. I'm just gonna put it down. I have a piece of plastic that I'm gonna wrap it in. But I'm actually gonna let this sit out for a little bit. I'm having a terrible time here. I'll let it sit out for a little bit. So I'm gonna flatten it. And let it have air for a little while. Then I'll get some of that moisture out that's causing this. Okay, so just washed all the red off my hands. I'm gonna dry them a little bit more. Get the red off of my countertop. And I'm just gonna show you the orange. So the orange I took out after 1 day of saponifying, and I wore gloves to work with it because it wasn't finished saponifying. And then I took it out again at 3 days, and then again today. So you can see this was just like the red at the first time I worked it. And you can see now it's much more workable. It's cured a little bit more, so it's not sticking to my hands. It's firmer, more firm, firmer. It's more firm than that red stuff is, because it's actually cured a little bit, even though it's wrapped up. But you can see it's totally workable. It's not really sticking very much to my hands. There's a few hard bumps in here. Well, really, not really. They've all been worked out pretty well. Oh, there's one. There's one over here. So I just mash those hard bumps that you feel. And this stuff is great, ready to work with. So I'm just gonna wad this back up, put it back down on its plastic wrap, and wrap it up. Okay. So let me show you the yellow. Okay. You see, I had the same problem with the yellow, not completely blended in. So I'm just mashing the hard parts here. There's hard bumps in there. See, that's really solid right there, but then when I mash it, it softens up. Just mashing the bumps. So the blue is a lot harder than any of the other colors have been. So I'm going to actually break this in pieces to work it. So it has cured quite a lot better than the other two have. So it's got the hard lumps in it, just like the other ones did, but it's not as sticky inside as the other colors you saw me work. Like, I could actually use this blue today, right now. It's good to go. Again, I'm just breaking up the bumps, trying to make it smooth. So when I make an embed out of this, I leave it exposed to the air, it cures. All the rest of the water comes out. And it makes a very hard piece of soap. This blue is actually almost hard to work with. It's so stiff. And so it's just the difference. Everything is the same. You saw that it came from the same thing. I just added blue mica to this instead of red or yellow or green or orange or blue, purple, I mean. So it's all about how much the micas can affect. So this one up really good. I don't want any air in it. Wash my hands, and I'm gonna clean this up and come back and show you the other ones I've worked with. So here's the green. I had it out a little earlier. I've been letting it sit a little bit to air. I'm gonna work it one more time. You can see it's very sticky, but it's less sticky than it was the first time I worked with it. Again, just trying to get as many of the bumps out of it as I can. And the first time I worked with this, it was just like the red or the yellow. It was just too goopy. And I just had to put it away, walk away from it for a while, and then come back. And there's still a few left in there, but they're pretty small. And you can see the dough's getting stickier the more I work with it. So we're gonna fold it up and put it away too. Okay, I'd say it's been about 15 minutes since I last worked with this red. It's been sitting out, still very sticky, but much less than it was 15 minutes ago. So I'm just going to try and get out a few more of the bumps. Thank you. So it was still pretty messy. So I'm going to put it away and work with it in 3 days. Okay. So the purple I worked with a couple of hours ago. It was just like the red and the green. It was really goopy and messy, just like they were. Still is, but I'm gonna come back, try and get some more of those bumps out of it. I think it was actually worse than the red. I think it was probably the goopiest of all of them that I did. And you know, it's still really soft, but you can see it's not sticking to me too bad. Going to the more I do, but it's already starting to get yucky. It was so bad earlier though that I had to just stop, and there were still big clumps of the harder soap in here, so before I put it away for 3 days, I wanted to try and get a few more out. So there's still quite a few smaller bumps in here. Just so happens they also happen to be the soap that doesn't have mica in it. But it's starting to just get super sticky, so I'm gonna put it to bed for 3 days. And then I'll come back and work it again. And it really should be pretty good to go by then. It should be just like that orange soap was.